once again, welcome to my YouTube channel. This is Peter Jan Palian and Amelio. And today, guys, I am going to discuss the different methods or ways of measuring liquid or dry ingredients.
Measuring ingredients. One of the keys to successful baking is the correct measurement of ingredients. One should not only follow the amount stated in a recipe, but also measure them in the right way. Dry and liquid ingredients are measured differently. Number one is our dry ingredients. Like flour and sugar, it is measured in a nested measuring cup, which come in a set of four. We can use 1 cup, 1 1/2 cup, 1/3 cup, and 1/4 cup. Then, the sugar and all-purpose flour are measured by dipping the caps into the ingredients until filled, then leveling it up with a spatula. For cake flour and confectioner sugar, the ingredients are spooned onto the cap, then leveled up. Next is the liquid ingredient. It is poured into spotted glass measuring cups placed on a flat surface. The measurement is read at eye level. Number 3 is the small quantities of dry and liquid ingredients. It is measured using spoon, measuring 1 tablespoon, 1 teaspoon, 1/2 teaspoon, or 1/4 teaspoon. The dry ingredients are leveled up with a spatula. Next in line is the sanitary health habit. It means keeping things clean is very important in bread and pastry. Letter A, always keep oneself clean. Keep our food clean. Keep the tools and equipment clean, and keep the laboratory clean. The helpful laboratory procedure. Before starting any baking work, see to it that everything in the kitchen is properly arranged, the working tables, utensils, tools, ingredients, and etc. Always wash the tools and equipment before and after using them. Store all ingredients in movable metal shelves for easy adjustment. Always cover the ingredients and place them in the proper containers. Prepare the pans needed, making sure you use the correct pan size. If it needs greasing, brush the bottom of the pan with a little shortening. For baking purposes, don't use butter or margarine for greasing because these burn easily and will produce a very brown crust. Measures the ingredients using correct utensils in the amount required in the recipe. Mix the butter or dough. When peeling pans, make sure you don't overpeel. Peel about 2/3 full to give an allowance for the rising. Bake in the preheated oven. Put the pan at the center rack. Test for doneness. For butter cake, prick the center of the cake with a toothpick. If it comes out clean, then it is done. Pour the chiffon in sponge cakes, press lightly with the fingers. If it spring back, then it is done. Pies and pastries are done when the crust have turned golden brown, crisp, and flaky. The safety practices. Regularly check all your kitchen equipments to prevent the accurate of mechanical hazards. Properly use of equipment, utensils, and tools according to their usage specifications. Refrain from smoking in your working area. Avoid wearing jewelries and other accessories while working. Always leave the room or the working area for the next user.
Don't forget to like, comment, share, and click the notification bell for more updates. Thank you for watching. I hope you learned more. So thank you and have a nice day.
Always do it on my own, so I gotta get through it. And the only thing I know is to love what I'm doing. Never give up, never slow, till I finally prove it. Never listen to the no's, I just wanna keep moving. Keep my head up when I act, head up, that's a fact. Never looking back, I'ma keep myself on track. Keep my head up, staying strong, always moving.